Chag Sameach, everyone. Happy Shavuot. I'm Rabbi Karen Bender, and I'm so happy to be here with Rabbi Ron Goldberg as we join you in celebrating this wonderful festival. So what is Shavuot, which many of you call Shavuos, the Yiddish pronunciation? Shavuos, or Shavuot, is the bookend to Passover. On Passover, we celebrate the Exodus from Egypt, as you know. And then we begin to count days in anticipation of Shavuot. We count 7 weeks, 7 times 7, 49 days, until we get to the 50th day, which is today. And on this holiday, we mark the receiving of the Torah at Mount Sinai. And so what we're going to do this morning, I'm very excited about. First, we're going to celebrate with Psalms of Praise, Hallel. Then we're going to chant the Ten Commandments. And then finally, as we do on Yom Kippur and Sukkot and Passover, we will pause for a moment of Yizkor, of remembering our loved ones, especially our mothers and fathers. And one last thing I want to share with you is that this, in addition to being a holiday that commemorates receiving the Ten Commandments, it's also an agricultural festival, just like Passover and Sukkot. And so with us, we have this fruit bowl of loquats from our very own Grandsell Village loquat trees.
And over here, we have our very own bowl of fruit. My wife is a longtime kibbutz member, and for the kibbutznikim, this is Chag HaBikurim, the holiday of the first fruits, so very, very important to them. Words of Hallel, songs of praise, are recited by the community on joyous and happy occasions. These dates are the cycle of the pilgrimage festivals, that would be Pesach, Shavuot, and Sukkot. And also it's done on Hanukkah, Rosh Chodesh, the beginning of the lunar month. The melodies, the nigunim, are typically upbeat and full of joy. What many don't realize is the words are a word-for-word recitation of Psalms 113 to 118. The overarching themes are of joy and thanksgiving to God, our Father in heaven. The words speak of the wondrous acts and goodness the Jewish people receive from God. I find great joy and great satisfaction in singing the words and hearing the enthusiasm of the congregation as we sing together. But I have to share, there is a phrase that's a bit off theme that speaks to me very loudly. Mina Meitzar Karatiya Anani B'merchavya Adonai Li Lo Yira. Roughly translated, from my deep distress, I called out to God, who answered me by setting me free. God is with me. I do not fear. Who of us has never been in a dark place, a place of dread where we saw no good solution or way of escape? I've had that experience many times in my life. It happens often late at night when everybody is asleep and the night is quiet. In that moment, I can't lie to myself anymore and say that everything is okay, because in that moment, I know the straits that I'm in. And in that moment, I offer that simple but deeply felt prayer directly from my heart and soul. God, please help me. I made the cry for help, and in God's way and time, help and solutions arrived. Not miracles, not magic, but if I allowed myself to be open to God's plan and open to working at being a partner with God in solving the problem, I can say from my distress I called out, and God answered me in partnership. The Hallel, words of thanksgiving, songs of praise, words of comfort and hope.
Beautiful introduction to Hallel, Rabbi Ron. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu likro et ha-Hallel.
Amen.
Hallelujah, 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 day Adonai, hallelujah, hallelujah, et shem Adonai. Betzeit Yisrael mi Mitzrayim, Beit Yaakov me'amdoes. Betzeit Yisrael mi Mitzrayim, Beit Yaakov me'amdoes. Hayta, hayta, Lekot Show, Israel, Mam Shlotav, Hayam Rahava, Yahanos, Hayardeni, Sov Lehachor, Betzeit Israel, Mimi Israel, Beit Yaakov, Meham Lohes. Hodu, hodu, Ladonai ki tov, ki leolam chasdo. Hodu, hodu, Ladonai ki tov, ki leolam chasdo. Yomar na Israel, ki leolam chasdo. Yomru na vedaharon, ki leolam chasdo. Hodu, hodu, Ladonai ki tov, ki leolam chasdo. Hodu, hodu, Ladonai ki tov, ki leolam chasdo. And in the beautiful words that Rabbi Ron reflected upon earlier, in my distress, I cried out to Adonai, who answered by setting me free. Min ha-metzar ka-ti-yah, anani va-merchav-yah. Min ha-metzar ka-ti-yah, anani va-merchav-yah. Anani, anani, anani va-merchav-yah. Anani, 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 va-merchavya. I give thanks to Adonai who answered me. Odecha ki hanitani, vatehi li lishua. Even masu habonim. Haita le rosh pina. Met Adonai haita hazot. Hi niflat beinenu. Eze hayom asa Adonai, nagila v'nismecha bo. Eze hayom asa Adonai, nagila v'nismecha bo. Ana Adonai, hoshiana. Ana Adonai, hoshiana. Adonai, hatzlichana, ana Adonai, hatzlichana.
Baruch atah Adonai, melech olam batish bachot. Praised are you, O Lord, sovereign of the universe, exalted by praise.
Having completed Hallel, we now make our way to Aseret HaDibrot, the Ten Commandments. But before we actually read the Ten Commandments, which is tradition on Shavuot, Rabbi Ron and I thought we might have a discussion with you about some of our favorite, if you can have favorites of the Ten Commandments, right? Isn't that our plan, Rabbi Ron?
It is. Not favorites, but ones we consider that touch us.
That's a good way to put it. You know, you're making me think about how, you know, we return to Torah and we see different parts of it that really speak to us at different times. So what I wanted to focus on are the first three of the Ten Commandments, because all three of the first three deal with God, with Hashem. The first one is actually not really a commandment. It's really a declaration. And basically it says, I am God. God is declaring God's self as God. The second commandment is commanding us to not make idols and to not have, in quotes, other gods besides me, is what God says. And then finally, the last of the three, of these first three, is to not take God's name in vain. That is to not swear by God's name or to curse by God's name, God forbid. And what's interesting to me about this is
there are 10 commandments, and three of them are dedicated not toward mitzvahs, not toward being a mensch, not toward giving tzedakah, which is, for example, one of the commandments that I've never understood isn't in the 10 commandments, but three of them are dedicated to the oneness of God and not creating an image of God, not creating an idol. And I asked myself, why would that be so important? What are the ethics? Because I believe that all of the mitzvot tie into ethics one way or another. And to me, the answer is this, and it's really revolutionary, considering that our ancestors came up with this 3,500 years ago. And that is that if you create an image of God, if you design a God, if you paint God, if you make an idol of God, then by definition, that idol, that image of God, is going to look more like some of us than like others. If the God image that you create is male, then what if somebody is female? If the God image that you create is Caucasian looking, what if someone is Semitic looking or Asian or Latino looking or African looking? If the God image that you create is walking or standing, what about those of us who are in a wheelchair? You see, by making God invisible, then you can really ensure that every person can feel, I am made B'Tselem Elohim. I'm made in God's image, as the book of Genesis promises, right? So that God is a divine image of what we wish for all of ourselves to be at our best. God isn't some, you know, item on a shelf or in a place where we bow down and that it's outside of ourselves. What do you think, Rabbi Ron?
I think my father would absolutely agree with you, because one of his big themes to me growing up was how unique and revolutionary this idea of one God was for its time and continues to be. For all the reasons that you said, that a God who we see ourselves in and see the other end, what do we say? See the divine spark in the other person? I think you've totally touched on all the things that I think make the divine so important to us and so much a part of our lives.
You know, so true. And, you know, this is a true story. Once I had my youngest child, my daughter Shoshi, we went to get donuts at a donut shop. And there was an altar with a couple of cups of coffee and a couple of donuts. And I was so curious. I asked the person behind the counter, I said, is this an altar of some sort? And they said, yes, we worship the God of this donut shop. And I remember that when we made our way out to the car, Shoshi said to me, hey, mom, are they right or are we right? And I said, about what? And she said, are there a bunch of gods, like a god of the donut shop, or is there only one God? And I said, well, that's a really good question. I'll tell you, they think that they're right and we think that we're right. And it's not about being right or wrong. It's really about, from our point of view, the ethics and values that are the cornerstone to the notion that God has to be invisible. Because if God is invisible and unknowable, then we can all image God in the way that is appropriate for us, or not image God at all, but rather just try to live in God's ways, as it were. What about you, Rabbi Ron? What's a commandment you would like to focus upon today?
We're going to run in order. We're going to go to number four. You know, Zachor Yom HaShabbat LeKodesho. Keep the Sabbath. You remember the Sabbath day to make it holy, that on the seventh day God rested. Therefore, you should rest also. You, your wife, your family, your slaves, everybody in the community, including both the non-Jew who lives among you and your animals. And what fascinates me about this commandment is how hard it is to keep and understand. It just says rest, don't work. Well, the legal mind in me says, what does work mean? How do you define work? I love that our sages, Chachamim Zichronam Livracha, are going to spend the next several centuries, even to this present day, trying to figure it, not so much figure it out, but to define it and define it for the world they live in. I love looking at questions I get today. Rabbi, is a microwave cooking? Is a microwave working? Is playing baseball work? I love that we continue to look at this very basic statement of honor the Sabbath day, keep Shabbat, keep it holy, and then trying to figure out in our generation, what does it mean? in my great grandmother's generation, when you had to make a fire, literally, we're rubbing those two rocks together to make a spark to create a fire, that was work. Is it work when I can go over to the stove and just turn a dial? These questions fascinate me. And yet I love that our Torah and the very basic documents of how we live gives us the space to discover that in each generation, that each generation can look at the world it lives in and apply it accordingly. I love that.
That is so true. And what a beautiful interpretation, Rabbi Ron. You know, as you were speaking, I was thinking about, you know, most of us, when we think about Shabbat, we picture the candlesticks, the Kiddush cup, and the challah, even though that ritual of the Shabbat dinner table would not evolve for hundreds and hundreds of years after this text was written. But I think there's something that a lot of us miss when we think about Shabbat, which is we think of it as a day of rest, generally for ourselves, like I shouldn't work, I should rest. But if you look carefully at the commandment, it has as much to do with business ethics, because what it's telling you is, yeah, of course you don't work, but you can't have anyone who works for you work. And so this could be seen as a primary text in labor rights. An unethical employer could have their employee work 7 days a week. They could have them work 20 hours a day. And if the employee were to say, well, I don't want to, then the employer, if there were no rules about it, could fire them and say, I'll get someone who will. And what this commandment says is you can't. And it makes the point, even an animal shouldn't work 7 days a week. God rested on the seventh day. Every living thing has the right to rest and get a break and have a weekend. And you could even say we invented the notion of the weekend when we constructed this notion of Shabbat. Could you give us a last word, Rabbi Ron, before we go on to read the actual commandments?
If the Jewish people's two biggest contributions to the world we live in are the idea of monotheism and the weekend, I say we've had enormous success and enormous impact on our world. Hug some out, Rabbi.
Thank you. Thank you, Rabbi Ron. Really, really good point, and I'm with you on all of that.
We're going to make our way now to Aseret HaDibrot, the actual Ten Commandments. And you know, we haven't had a minyan in person in a long time, but we've got a lot of people together on this Shavuot morning, and I think that we could make an aliyah as a community. So I want to ask you, wherever you are, in your room or in a dining room or wherever you are, to join me in this aliyah. Baruchu et Adonai Hamvorach. Baruch Adonai Avorach Leolam Vahem. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Asher bachar banu mikol ha'amin v'natan lanu et torato baruch ata Adonai noten ha'torah. Or you can just say, amen. Here goes the Ten Commandments. Amen. V'idaber Elohim et kol ha'dvarim ha'ele lemor. Anochi Adonai Elohecha asher hotzeticha. Me'eretz Mitzrayim b'beit avadim. Lo yehe lecha Elohim acherim al panai. Lo ta'aseh lecha fesel v'chol tmunah asher b'shamayim mima'al v'asher ba'aretz mitachat v'asher b'mayim mitachat la'aretz. Lo tishtachave lahem velo ta'avdem, ki anochi Adonai Elohecha el kanah poked avon avot al banim al shileshim ve'al ribeim leson ahai ve'oseh chesed lalafim. Le'ohavai ulshomrei mitzvotai lohotisa et shem Adonai Elohecha lashav ki lohoyinake Adonai et asher isa et shmoho lashav zachor et yom haShabbat lekadsho sheheshet yamim ta'avod. Ve'asihita Kol melachtecha ve'yom hashvi'i Shabbat Adonai Elohecha lo ta'aseh chom lachah atah uvinchah uvitecha avdechah v'amatcha uvehemtecha v'gerchah asher bishavecha ki sheshet yamim asadom nahai et hashamayim v'et ha'aretz et hayam v'et kol asher baham v'yanach b'yom hashvi'i alken b'herach Adonai et yom hashabbat v'yikadshehu kabed et avicha v'et imecha lema'an ya'arichun yamecha al ha'adamah asher Adonai Elohecha noten lach lo tirzach lo tinaf lo tignov lo ta'aneh v're'achah ed shaker lo tachmod beit re'echa lo tachmod Eshet re'echa ve'avto va'amato ve'shoro v'chamaro ve'chol asher le'erecha. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natah lanu Torat emet v'chayei olam atah b'dochenu Baruch atah Adonai Noten HaTorah. Amen.
Amen. Yasher Koach, Rabbi. Let me just repeat these in English now so we know what we've all agreed to. First commandment, I am the Lord your God. Second, you shall have no other gods before me. Third, you do not take God's name in vain. Fourth, remember the Shabbat day. Fifth, honor your father and mother. Sixth, do not commit murder. Seven, do not commit adultery. Eight, do not steal. Nine, do not bear false witness. And 10, as Rabbi expounded on a few moments ago, do not covet anything of your fellows. All of these are, to me, are just the basic building blocks to a great society.
Rabbi Ron, that was so wonderful. And I love how you said, let's look at what we're committing ourselves to, because that's really the essence of Shavuot. Sometimes I compare Shavuot to a long-term marriage. Imagine something, and I know that this is absolutely ridiculous, but imagine if a spouse and another spouse, a husband and wife, sat down on their anniversary every year and said, hey, do you still want to be married to me? And the other one said, hey, do you still want to be married to me? And the one said, yeah, sure, let's go ahead for another year at least. And the other one said, yeah, let's go ahead. And they move forward that way. In a way, that's what Shavuot is. Every Shavuot, God and the Jewish people have coffee, as it were, or maybe champagne, and say, you know, I like you, but do you want to stay in this relationship with me? And if the Jewish people are asking God, they're saying, God, do you still want to be our God? And God says, sure. And then God says to the Jewish people, as a collective people, but also to us as individuals, how about you? Do you still want to be Jewish? Do you still want to live by Torah? Do you still want to live by the Ten Commandments? And in essence, when we celebrate Shavuot, we stand at Mount Sinai and we say, yes, yes, I say yes to that. I affirm the commitment that my ancestors made on my behalf. And I do want to live by Torah and be in this sacred relationship with the Jewish people and with God. And I just thank you, Ron, for Rabbi Ron, for putting it that way. We're going to make our way now toward our Yisker service. But before we do, we wanted to offer a couple of blessings. First, a blessing of healing. And in this unusual era that we're living in, I want to make this not only a blessing of healing for those who are sick, but I also want to make this a blessing of staying healthy for those who are well, and a blessing for the caregivers who keep us healthy, the amazing medical staff and all staff here at the Los Angeles Jewish Home. Misha Beirach Avotenu, Avraham Yitzchak Yaakov, V'imotenu, Sara Rivka Rachel V'Leah. May the one who blessed our ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah, send your healing upon all members of the community of the Los Angeles Jewish Home. Send your blessing of healing to those who need it that live with us. Send your blessing for those who need it that serve on staff here, volunteers, people who support the Jewish Home. Please, God, send your blessing of healing to all who need it. Also, send your blessing of health that those who are here on staff, that live here, that are part of our community anyway, that are thankfully healthy and well, that we remain this way and stay safe and stay able to keep giving to each other and keep loving in the way that every member of the Los Angeles Jewish community, Los Angeles Jewish Home community does. And we ask a special blessing upon our caregivers, the nurses, the doctors, all of the hands-on staff, and the staff that's behind the scenes, that they and all of their loved ones should know continued health and joy. Amen.
Amen. I like that an awful lot, that you're linking our tradition, that idea that it's a marriage renewed, because also at Sinai, God told Moses and Aaron, when you bless the people, here are the words I want you to use. So I'm going to bless the community here in the same words that God commanded Moses and Aaron to use. Yivarecha Adonai v'yishmerecha, Ya'er Adonai panav elecha v'yikunecha, Yisa Adonai panav elecha, v'esem lechem shalom. May God guard and protect you. May he turn his face to you. May he be gracious to you. And most importantly, give us all the blessing of peace. We say, Amen.
Amen.
We go into the Yisker service. We do this over the course of the year several times. And for me, it's so very important that this idea of remembrance, and we've talked about it in the past, but I want to take a little slightly different tack today. I want to take a moment just to sit with my mom and dad, to hear my father's voice reciting the Shema, to hear my mother taking a look at me in my shelter-in-place haircut and hear her say, Ronala, you should get a haircut. I want to hear her say that to me one more time. So in today's Yisker service, I'm going to indulge myself by spending a few minutes with my parents.
And we invite all of you to follow Rabbi Ron's example and spend some moments with your own parents and your own loved ones who have passed on this Shavuot Yisker. We're going to begin this part of our morning by reading a reflection that has been written by Rabbi Harold Schulweis, Zichrono Livracha.
We are not to close our eyes to death, nor are we to pretend that our grief, our mourning, our ache are all unreal. We have learned the price of such denial and evasion. The momentary relief it may bring us is followed by an overwhelming despair the next day.
Pain, suffering, death are real and must be confronted with emotional honesty. Beyond that, the vacuum left in the wake of our loss must be filled with a creative memory, with a remembrance which leads to activity. Death must be overcome by deeper living, fear by more courageous faith, remorse by stronger resolve.
We Jews believe in an immortality of influence. We believe no gesture of goodness is swallowed up into oblivion. There is a conservation of moral energy within the goodness expressed in the lives of those we remember is transformed into our own attitudes and behavior towards life. The past is not over. It flows into the present towards the dreams of the future.
The immortality of those whom we honor and remember lies in the eternity of our people and its purpose, to repair the world, to unite the fragmented, to bind the wounds of the bruised.
The Yeshkor is not alone for those who have sustained the loss of relatives. It is a prayer of the collective memory of a people who have lived to sanctify our world, for those who have transcended the narrow boundaries of the self to find the other. Let no Jew feel that he is exempt from such meditation and memory. Let him not leave the sanctuary to others. Let's join together to unite the three time dimensions of our Jewish being, to recall who we were, who we are, and who we must become.
Adonai, ma adam v'tedaehu, ben enosh v'techashvehu, adam lahevel dama yamav ketzel over.
Adonai, who are we that you should care about us? Who are we that you take note of us?
Shiviti Adonai l'negdi tamid, ki mimini balemot. Lachen samach libi ve'agel kvodi af besari ishkon lavetach.
I am ever mindful that God is with me. Adonai is at my right hand. I shall not fail. So my heart rejoices and my soul exalts and my body rests in safety. Mizmor leDavid, a psalm of David. Adonai roi v'lo achsar. V'not deshet v'yarbitzeni. Almei menuchot yachalani. Adonai is my shepherd, I shall not want. God lies me to lay down in green pastures and guides me to calm waters. God renews my life, guiding me on the right path, for that is God's way. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no harm, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a banquet for me in the presence of my adversaries. You moisten my head with oil. My cup overflows. Let but goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Shir lema'alot, a song of ascent. Esa einai el harim. Me'ayin yavo Ezri. Ezri me'im Adonai Ose shamayim v'aretz. I lift up my eyes to the mountains. What is the source of my help? My help comes from Adonai, maker of heaven and earth.
This is the hour of Yeshkor, when we remember our loved ones who have passed away. Many of us remember a husband or a wife. We remember our brothers and sisters whose lives ended before our own. Some of us, tragically, recall a son or daughter, and no one can know their pain. But all come to Yeshkor, are united by having lost a mother, a father, or both.
Let us take a moment now for silent and private reflection and memory by the light of the Yahrzeit candle. And now the prayer and memory of our Jewish martyrs.
Yizkor Elohim Nishmo Kol Achenu B'nei Yisrael Shemashru Et Nafsham Al Kiddush Hashem. May God be mindful of the souls of all our family, departed members of the House of Israel, who sacrificed their lives for the sanctification of God's holy name and the honor of Israel. Grant that their heroism and self-sacrificing devotion find response in our own hearts and the purity of their souls be reflected in our lives. May their souls be bound up in the bonds of life eternal, an everlasting blessing among us. And let us say, Amen.
Amen. The memorial prayer for the departed is known as El Male Rahamim. El Male Rahamim, Shochein Vamromim, Hamseim Inucha Nechona, Tachat Kanfei Ashrina, Bemalot Kedoshim Utehorim, Kezohar Haraki Hamazirim, Et Nishmohot Kol Eile, Shehiskarnu Hayom Libracha, Shehalechu Lulamam, Began Eheden Tehimenu Chahatam, Anabahal Harachamihim, Hastirehem Beseter, Knafecha Leholamim. Ve'yitzror bitzror hachayim et nishmotehem, Adonai hu nachalatam, ve'anuchu beshalom al mishkevotehem, ve'nomar, Amen.
Amen. O merciful God who dwells on high, and yet is full of compassion, keep in your divine presence among the holy and pure, those whose light shines as the brightness of the firmament, the souls of our dear and beloved who have gone to the eternal home with you. May their souls be bound in the bond of life, and their memories inspire us to serve you and humanity in truth, in kindness, and peace. Amen.
Amen. We turn now to the Mourner's Kaddish, and I imagine most of you don't have it in front of you, but Rabbi Ron and I will read it very slowly so that you can repeat each word or phrase after us. And we think about the fact that the Mourner's Kaddish, even though we associate it with grief, doesn't say a word about death. It's all about optimism, hope, a vision for the future, and a dream of peace, both in our world and Shleimut and wholeness, peace and wholeness inside of ourselves. So in honor of all of your loved ones that you remember this day, this eighth day of Passover, during this Yisker service when we are together, if not physically, certainly in spirit, we join now in the Mourner's Kaddish.
Yit Gadol V'Yit Kadosh Shemei Rabbah Yalma Di Bra Firote Yamlich Malchute Bachayechon Uvyomechon Uvchaye Dechol Beit Yisrael Baagala Uvizman Kariv Vimru Amen.
Yehe Shmei Rabbah Mevorach Leolam Ul'almei Almaya.
Yit Barach V'yishtabach V'yit Pa'ar V'yit Roman V'yit Nasei V'yit Adar V'yit Ale V'yit Alal Shmei Dekudasha Berich Hu Le'ela Nin Kol Birchata Bishirata Tushbachata Benechamata Damiran Bialman Vimru Amen.
Amen. Yehe Shlama Rabba Min Shemaya Vechayim Aleinu Ve'alkol Yisrael Ve'imru Amen.
Ose Shalom Bimromav. Hu Yase Shalom Aleinu Ve'al Kol Yisrael Vimru Amen.
Amen.
Zichronam Livracha, may their memories be for a blessing.
And we all say Amen.
Amen.
Well, my friends, we're going to conclude now with a couple of songs. Maybe you know them, maybe you don't, but I hope that you'll end with a smile and with peace in your hearts. Esaynai el heharim, I am Yahavo Yahavo Hezri. Esaynai el heharim, I am Yahavo Yahavo Hezri. Hezri mehim Adonai, Ose shamayim ba'aretz. Esaynai el heharim, me'ayin Yahavo Hezri. Esaynai el heharim, heharim Yahavo Yahavo Hezri. Hezri mehim Adonai, Ose shamayim ba'aretz. Hezri mehim Adonai, Ose shamayim ba'aretz. Ose shalom bimromav, hu yase shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'imru imru amen. Yase shalom, yase shalom, shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael. Yase shalom, shalom aleinu el kol Yisrael. Yase shalom, shalom aleinu ve el kol Yisrael. Yase shalom, shalom aleinu ve el kol Yisrael.
Chag Sameach.
Chag Sameach, everyone!
יום מיוחד הגיע ובא, יודעים אתם מתי קיבלנו התורה. יום מיוחד הגיע ובא, יודעים אתם מתי קיבלנו התורה. בחג שבועות קיבלנו התורה, נודה לאלוקים זו מתנה נפלאה. בחג שבועות נלבש לבן, את התורה קיבלנו ברובם. בחג שבועות קיבלנו התורה, נודה לאלוקים זו מתנה נפלאה. בחג שבועות נלבש לבן, את התורה קיבלנו ברובם. יום מיוחד הגיע ובא, יודעים אתם מתי קיבלנו התורה. יום מיוחד הגיע ובא, יודעים אתם מתי קיבלנו התורה. בחג שבועות קיבלנו התורה, נודה לאלוקים זו מתנה נפלאה. בחג שבועות נלבש לבן, את התורה קיבלנו ברובם.